everybody. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Madden 17 on EA Sports. Here we've got a couple of big targets who will try to be key contributors in both the pass and run games today. It's Ertz's Eagles going up against Graham's Seahawks. So with kickoff straight ahead, we'll check in with our broadcast team. Here are Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you very much, Larry. While the skies may be ominous, there's never a bad day for football. Coming up, we've got what should prove to be a good one between the Philadelphia Eagles and the Seattle Seahawks. Hi again, everybody. Alongside my partner, Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. And Charles, we saw Larry focus on the tight end matchup in his open. You think it's one to watch, don't you?
Definitely one to watch because these guys can create such big plays by all the different things they can do. Line up out wide, in the slot, line up in a normal tight end position, and then who are you going to cover them with? Is it a linebacker, a defensive back? They create mismatches all throughout the game.
To return, this is Doug Baldwin. Oh, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle him.
So out come the Seahawks now for their first possession. They'll be led out by a man who's been a Pro Bowler in three of his first four NFL seasons. From Wisconsin, it's Russell Wilson.
Coming out of college, he graded out A-plus in every category you want in a quarterback, except height. And that's what moved him to a third-round pick. And we all found out later that was a mistake. He should have been a first-round guy. Now, in 2015, he showed his ability to actually lead a team to victories by being able to throw the football, not just rely on the running game.
Yeah, they're going to get this one all the way out across the 45.
In recent years, the slot receivers really gained stature in the NFL because they could do so many things. Yes, they can line up wide like your normal wide receiver, but to have that kind of courage and toughness to run routes in the middle of the field and become dependable targets for their quarterbacks and move the sticks, those guys are worth their weight in gold.
And it pops free. The collision there jarred the ball loose and brings up second down. And this O-line, it is the lifeblood of the offense.
They established the tone. Mean, nasty, physical. They can't wait to get after people. That allows the rest of the offense to feel confident.
Second down now after the incompletion. Second and 10. It's Wilson hit. It's loose. It's out. Fumble. But I believe a Seahawk was able to get a handle on this, so this will remain Seattle ball. So it goes as a fumble, but the key thing, not a fumble loss.
Yeah, that stat's big, isn't it? I mean, I remember watching teams play. The ball might be on the ground a number of times during the game, but if the other team doesn't get it, that's a huge difference in the ball game. And in this case, they were able to retain possession.
So the offense able to recover the fumble, but it's third down now. Third and long, it's Wilson. Complete, Richardson has it. And he's brought down after a good game. The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Well, the advantage has certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions, had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
So after that big play, let's see if they can catch their defense maybe on their heels. On first down, Wilson. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he's brought down after a good game. It goes as a pickup of 23. And it'll give the Seahawks a first down. From the red zone now, here's Wilson on. And he's got it. Caught in the end zone for the Seahawk touchdown. Paul Richardson, a 14-yard touchdown. And the Seahawks take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive. And with the rules as touchy as they can be, it's so hard to complete a diving catch in the end zone, but he just did it pretty well.
How about him getting his body, his hands, everything underneath and around the football without it hitting the ground and causing some doubt in the minds of the people who have to look at this and possibly review it. What a tremendous effort and a great catch.
And he knocks it through. Now to send this one away following the score. On the return now, it's Josh Huff. Oh, look at that.
Oh, look at him turn.
And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. So now here comes the Eagles offense as they get ready to take over. They'll be led out by the former Heisman Trophy winner and number one overall pick from Oklahoma. It's Sam Bradford.
And Sam Bradford, he has touch and accuracy, and he has it in bushels. This guy is amazing. If you watch him throw 7-on-7 or watch him throw routes versus air, the ball hardly ever hits the ground. He's absolutely a receiver's dream when going out for a pass.
And this defense feeling the encouragement. They stop him at the line of scrimmage on the first play of the afternoon. No gain, and it's second down. And the tight end, Zach Ertz, is key in this offense as we get a look at the starters.
Comes out of the factory known as Stanford, which keeps putting out tight ends. Zach Ertz, one of the better ones we've seen in recent years.
Fake to Matthews. Now Bradford. Rush coming and he's taken down. Cliff Averill in there to make the sack. He buries him for a loss of 10.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
A dump off to Sproles. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll bring up fourth down.
That's certainly playing down in distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
Now Donnie Jones, an original seventh-round pick of the Seahawks, on to punt it away. Back deep for the Seahawks, the all-pro returner from 2015, Tyler Lockett. Now it's Lockett. Well, nice job on the return there, 16 yards. And the Seahawks will have great field position to start this drive. They take over on the short side of the field. And the Seahawks get ready to trot out on the field. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And the defense now for the Eagles.
Jordan Hicks played inside and outside linebacker while in college. He'll do the same in the NFL and make a lot of plays in doing so.
Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
As tight ends go, he might not provide the super flashy plays very often, but he's pretty reliable, usually an excellent target, and normally catches what's thrown to him, but he didn't on that play.
Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass. On third down, Wilson. He's got Curse. And he's able to pick up the first before he's taken down at the 27. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. Backing up. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
There was no trace of nervousness there. He was able to diagnose that play from his linebacker position, stay in excellent coverage, and bat the ball away.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. This will be caught inside the 10. That he's brought down. 19 yards on the pickup there, and now they'll have it first and goal. Carry for Thomas Rawls. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of five there, bringing up second. Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. A running play for Rawls. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. They do get six, but they still got some work to do on third and goal. Rawls. And a loose football. Rawls loses it. And fortunately for him, he's able to get it back. But it will be a loss on the play.
All I can say about this play is that someone's living right. I mean, he's trying to gain yardage, trying to get upfield. Ball comes free. What's that panic that we've talked about oftentimes that you feel when you lose the ball?
You can sense it.
Oh, you can sense it. And somehow he got to it and was able to recover it for a squad.
And Hauschka's kick is good. And the lead moves to 10-0. So 3 points is the outcome, but probably not what they're looking for given the drive that they were on.
Yeah, things were looking good. You had it first and goal, but then the offense sputters a bit, and they're forced to settle for a field goal.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And on the first drive, three and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning of a game still, don't you?
Those don't ever go away. And typically, what I've heard from guys and what I remember from playing, if you don't have nerves at the start of a game, it's not going to be a great day for you. You're not really ready to play. So finding a way to harness those nerves and not let them affect you in a negative way, that's what all the guys are looking for.
Carter, your thoughts on this D-line?
I love a unit that can control the run and get after the passer. This is an all-around terrific defensive front. Hard to move the ball against them on the ground, and then when you want to throw it, look out. Here they come after the quarterback.
So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. They go play action. Now Bradford. He's got time in the pocket. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Well, the great coach said football is really a simple game. Rush theirs, protect yours. And he's talking about those guys throwing the football. In this situation, the rush won, hitting the quarterback and forcing him into an incompletion.
On third down, Bradford. And this is caught on the sideline. But no, they'll say out of bounds. He caught it, but was not in bounds. Incomplete. Here's Donnie Jones now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. A third down, he tried to stay in bounds, did all he could. He caught it, but was led a little bit too far.
Yeah, and that's always difficult, isn't it? Because you know half of your body is trying to stay behind, while the other half is reaching out, trying to catch the football. The top half worked. It was the bottom half that was in question.
Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Second and 10. It's Wilson again. And incomplete there. A nice hit. Jars the ball free and brings up third down. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. And the Eagles will go with an extra DB here as they prepare for a stop on third.
Thinking pass all the way.
Now it's Wilson. Looking for Lockett, and it's intercepted. And an alley to run. And he takes this one back into the end zone. And the Eagles defense gets a pick six TD. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes get real wide, don't they?
How about the anticipation on the play? Reading, reacting, and then the ability to catch the football and take it in the opposite direction.
Caleb Sturgis now for the point after. Oh, this is blocked. One quarter down. 10-6 the score. We'll be back to Seattle right after this.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade, the sports fuel company.
Back live with Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two, as we'll see one following the score on the final play before break. Fielded about a yard deep. Fights off another.
I think the second tackler would have learned from the first.
So let's glance at a player spotlight now with Russell Wilson. He's had one of those games that any quarterback loves, not only being able to complete some passes, but some deep passes.
And it's pretty to watch. I mean, it's an absolute joy to see, but let's face it, we got to give a little bit of credit where it's deserved, right?
Well, the protection's been great.
The protection's been phenomenal, but how about how it's been spotlighted, right? Our producer, Christian McLeod, our director, Kyle Burt, the rest of the crew, what they put together with these images and pictures, if you're an offensive lineman, that's what you're taking with you to contract time.
They're going to have a lot to take to contract time if this continues. On second down, Wilson. No, he almost had it. Already with one interception, just missing his second there.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
To throw is Wilson. And Wilson has it. And he's brought down after a good game. And they convert on third with a gain of 22. Now the fourth-year man from Texas A&M, Kristen Michael. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. They run again with Michael. And he takes it across midfield to the 45. It'll be a gain of 7, and they get it back to a 3rd and 3. On the carry, Michael. And he'll push his way up to about the 44 here. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it's going to leave him with a 4th down.
Well, forget knowing where the first down line was.
His defense created their own line of scrimmage. They won every battle up front. And a lot of times that is one-on-one. And if you win your one-on-ones enough times, your defense is going to be pretty good. They have more people to the football and snapped out the play.
Completes it to Lawler. It's a gain of 7. And on fourth down, they're able to convert and move the sticks.
I remember pregame when we were talking to him on the field, and he took his gloves off and showed us his fingers. A few misshapen ones in there, and now we know why, trying to catch those types of bullets.
That was a dart. Yeah, even for a talented receiver, those are tough to hang on to. Now the offense lining up first and 10. Now Wilson on first down. And incomplete, a drop there in the middle third of the field. That'll bring up second down.
On any passes in the middle of the field, anyone who's going after the football is going to be conscious that it's probably going to be contested, and often physically. Sometimes that leads to drops.
Again on second and 10, it's Wilson. Complete, Richardson has it. And he gets it all the way down inside the 10 to the 5-yard line.
Usually hitting a deep post pattern, as we just saw there, for a big gainer. That's tough to do because you usually have a safety or two in the middle of the field. But if you hit enough crossers and underneath routes and curls, start to get those guys creeping up, wanting to make plays on the football. It's the equivalent of a changeup in baseball. You show your other stuff, throw the changeup, and on that play, it worked for big yardage.
And now a first down following that long gain. To throw again is Wilson. Incomplete.
It's always a good play when you're able to bat a ball away or down, because if you actually tip it in the air, now the offense is getting a second shot at catching the football, or another receiver may come along and grab it out of the air and turn it into a big play. So if you make a play on the ball, make sure it's knocked away or down. Otherwise, there could be some jeopardy.
Give him right around 4 on the carry. We'll see if they want to keep pounding here on third and goal. Now third down and goal from the 1. What a stand so far defensively, and now that's going to bring up a 4th and goal. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. This is less than an extra point, just a 19-yard attempt. And Hauschka's kick is good, and that'll open the lead up to a touchdown now at 13-6. So they get 3, they were hoping for 6, an unlucky number 13 play drive.
Well, you go to the sideline after putting 3 points on the board, happy, but you wanted to be ecstatic. You wanted to have 6 on the board. On the opposite sideline, though, the defense, I think they're high-fiving each other, only giving up 3 after letting them run that much offense.
And a short kick, taking it about the 16. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get it up to the 29-yard line. Philadelphia getting sent to take the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Ryan Matthews. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
Well, not a huge game there as we head towards the 2-minute warning. It'll be interesting to me to see what they decide to do after the timeout.
Again, we'll see the pistol here.
Here we go now. 390.
On second down, Ryan Matthews. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. Give him 8 yards there. Still a few inches to go, though, as it'll be third down at about the length of the football. We remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll pay a visit to Larry Ridley in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. short yardage, Bradford. And this is going to be incomplete. Jordan Matthews is what he was looking for. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Well, they've had a pretty frustrating first half here offensively, and then just continued there with that incompletion.
Yeah, definitely frustrating for them, but heartening for the other guys. Those stop troops, they're enjoying things right now. They made it very difficult for them throughout the half.
And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. And out now come the Seahawks. And they had 3 points last time, but they didn't want 3 points because they were well within range of scoring a touchdown. We'll see if they can do better now.
I'm with you on that one. Let's just go ahead and be frank about the whole thing. The only one happy about the 3 point
the kicker.
Exactly. You put it through the post. That's going to help him in contract time. But that offense, they're thinking, let's get in the end zone this time.
I don't know if that helped him in contract time. You could have kicked that one through.
I don't know about that.
Toe bash.
I don't know about
toe
that.
Bash.
Super toe. The name of the game is always on defense, put pressure on the quarterback. And that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
There's Wilson to throw, surveying the field. And his throw is going to be incomplete. So incomplete on second down. Now they'll look to convert here on third. On third down, Wilson. And that will be incomplete as well.
That's a really fine play there because anytime you see a comeback route, that means you cannot just stay in one spot and make a play on the ball. You've got to move your feet and move with the receiver, and that's exactly what he did.
Now they're going to fake it from deep in their own territory. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And the fake will work. He's going to have a first down. It's a big play that time on the fake punt. And on fourth and long, somehow they're able to keep the drive going.
I always enjoy a good fake, but I really enjoy it when he throws the football from punt formation. Now, you were a kicker and a punter in high school. Did you ever do that?
One time, threw to my man Tim Jones on a botched field goal attempt, hit him right in the numbers, and Jonesy just dropped it.
Oh, the poor guy. Well, we had a fake punt here, and this guy caught it, so I think he and his friends will be okay with that one.
And he loves his play call, right? He's been waiting for this one all week long.
Been had that arm loosened up ever since they got to the stadium.
His throw caught at about the 5. A good pickup there at 22. And the offense moving quickly to the line. On the ground, Rawls. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal. And here comes play number 6 on this drive. And now it's second and goal. On second down, Rawls. And he is going to lose yardage here. They'll wind up losing 3. And now it's third down. 2 straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have 2 remaining here before we get to halftime. So the offense took the timeout. Looks like they're ready to go as we get set to resume the action. And Hauschka's kick is good. And that will push the lead up to double digits now at 10. It's a little bit of time left here in the second quarter, but they get the field goal near the end of the first half to expand that lead.
Now that's got to feel good, but they can't let up. Now on the kickoff, they've got to make sure they don't give up a big return or a big yardage to set up the other team for one last chance to score themselves.
Now after the made field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will... And now the Seahawks are going to call another timeout. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. The defense, they got a little bit of a breather. Now they're back and set as we resume play.
Three, 39,
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll go down right at the 30-yard line. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3. Second down throw for Bradford. Finding time. A dump off to Sproles. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. Call it a gain of 7, and it gets him a new set of downs.
There we go now. 390.
A first down throw for Bradford. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left.
Give him credit for batting it away, but unable to come up with the interception, and sometimes that joke does come true. Guys are on defense for a reason. Maybe their hands aren't quite as skillful as the guys on offense, but a lot of credit on that play for just knocking it away.
And his throw is incomplete. So we reach halftime here in a 10-point game as we send you cross-country to our EA Sports studios in Orlando with our halftime report. Here's Larry Ridley.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report. Let's take a look back at the first half. The Seahawks are happy to be in front, and they'll look to play another solid half of football. The Eagles, on the other hand, want to quiet this crowd and turn things around. All right, let's get straight to it. Here's some highlights from the first half. Third down from the 42. The pass ends up being picked off. Eagles will end up returning it for a TD. The Eagles trail now by 4. Seahawks with the ball early in the second. Paul Richardson hauling in the pass in traffic. And he'll end up at the 5-yard line before being tackled. Unfortunately, they would have to settle for just a field goal. Fourth down from the 20. And he'll end up at the 25-yard line before being tackled. But they end up coming away with just 3 on the drive. That'll do it for us here at EA Sports Studios. Let's get back out to Brandon and Charles for the call of the second half. Brandon.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. Here's Huff to return. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Out come the Eagles now as they'll go on offense first here in the third quarter. They have the ball here for the inaugural drive of the second half. Pretty big deficit, though. We'll see what adjustments were made in that locker room.
And I never want to make something more important than it actually is, right? I don't want to create more hype than what is there.
This is
I'm doing it, though. This is a really important drive. And we often talk about teams scripting plays to start a game. A lot of them script to start the second half, too. And they're scripting something that they expect to get them into the end zone and back into this game.
We'll see if that script is a good one for them.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still, a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well.
And that's a nice pickup of a first down on that second down run. And at that yardage gained, they can run that plan any down.
They come up in an offset eye. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46. Earl Thomas in on the stop. Second down following the run.
Well, so far, this game has gone the way the defensive coordinator had hoped. They've dictated things. They've not let them run the ball very well at all. They gave up a nice game there. I doubt it'll back off their confidence. They've played so well throughout this entire game.
And he'll take it down shy of the 45 at the 46.
That's a good, nice, crisp run for a first down. I wonder if the defense might have been loosened up a little bit, maybe anticipating a pass instead of the run that they got.
Here we go. 339.
First down, Bradford. Left side, caught by Matthews. It'll be a pickup of only 1 yard, and it'll be a 2nd down.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Sproles. And he's going to be met at about the 43. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to third down. And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Once again, they go with Sproles. And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. It's a gain of 5, and now the question, will the offense stay out there on 4th and 1? So now on is Caleb Sturgis for the Eagle field goal. This officially a 55-yard attempt. Oh, they get to the football. It's blocked.
Those really long field goals, when they are made, they are things of beauty. But there is a danger to getting them started, isn't there?
Yeah, with that low drive, you've got to really keep it low to the ground, don't you, to get that distance.
Yeah, hard to just pop it up in the air because otherwise it's not going to get there. So he's got to drive it low in order to have the distance. And that usually puts it in jeopardy, gives him a chance to block it. And everyone knows it on the other side. That's when you get your best jumpers on the other side of the field to try and get up and get it.
On first down, out to the right here to Wilson. And he is taken down deep in Philadelphia territory. That one goes for 36 yards. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Wilson. This will be caught at about the 3. And he will score. Touchdown, Seattle. Luke Wilson. A 16-yard touchdown, and the Seahawks add on to their lead.
The big fellow was the recipient there for that touchdown pass, and it seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to worry about most in the passing game.
Hauschka now for the extra point. And that'll make this a 3-score game as the lead moves to 17. Now to send this one away following the score. Now it's Barner. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. Last time out, they had that long 50-plus yard field goal that they missed.
And I'm sure on their sideline they're thinking to themselves, okay, do we still want to try one if we're in that position again? And I would dare say that the answer would be yes. They're going to have a lot of confidence in their kicker. But just to be on the safe side, I'm sure they told their offensive guys, can we get a little bit closer this time?
Yeah, get a little closer.
Yeah, well, you know, I'd rather get in the end zone first and foremost. But if all else fails, less of a field goal attempt for him.
10th carry now for Ryan Matthews. And he'll get this up to about the 38-yard line. It'll be a pickup of a couple, and it leaves him with a 3rd and 3.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Now Ryan Matthews on 3rd down. And he is going to lose yardage here. Losing 2 yards that time, and now it's 4th down.
Brandon, that play ended so fast, it's almost as if the quarterback handed it to the runner and the tackler was there right away for a loss of yardage.
He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. And great special teams work here. This is knocking on the door of the 5. They'll spot it at the 6-yard line. Here come the Seahawks now, set to take over on offense. And they were able to punch it in the end zone last time. They'll be looking to do that again here for the defense. Obviously, they'll be looking to stop them from punching it back in the end zone.
It always is punch-counter-punch, isn't it? And which team has the advantage? Well, let's just go back. Last time on offense, they rolled downfield, got into a good rhythm. You can see a little more bounce in and out of the huddle. You can see the sideline really get into the game. So defensively, you're thinking to yourself, how do we take that away from them? How do we get the advantage back? Let's see what they come up with. I think pressure is always the first way to go.
You love pressure.
I love it.
We'll see if they dial it up this drive. So a ways to go here on third and 10. Throwing is Wilson. And he's got Lockett. A pickup of 24 on the third down conversion. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve. And they're going to speed things up here. Here's Wilson to throw. It's caught. Lockett. They'll get 23 yards there. And the Seahawks are going to have a first down. They'll throw on first down with Wilson. It's complete to Lockett. And he's going to get this inside the 30. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Now Wilson on first down. This will be caught inside the 10. And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. Now Wilson, oh, it's incomplete. That would have been big in the end zone if he could have held on. Instead, it's second down. Push his way forward down to about the 3-yard line. They get 3 yards closer, but still work to do. It's third and goal. So a little extra time to ponder this third and goal as we played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now in Seattle, Washington. It's the Seahawks with the possession. They also have the lead here as we get set for the fourth and final quarter. From the 3-yard line once more. Now here's third and goal. They run with a power back. Rawls. And he'll keep working toward that end zone as he's down to about the 2-yard line. Only a yard that time, so now a decision to be made here on fourth and goal. So they'll turn to the kicker again. He's been a busy man thus far. From the left hash, he'll have to cut this at a tight angle.
That run didn't get very far, and I think when you're looking at his dimensions, he's a little bit on the smaller side. He's counting on the big guys up front to escort him in, and they couldn't create any kind of space for him, could they?
Yeah, didn't get the push they needed. So it's an old-school extra point, but certainly a disappointment that they couldn't get 6.
Yeah, when you see 19-yard field goal in the box score, you kind of shake your head. But their head coach decided 3 was enough.
Now after the main field goal, Hauschka back out onto the field to kick it away. This one taken from the 7. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. Philadelphia getting set to take the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore.
And the Seahawk defense gets to him and they bring him down. Cliff Avril in there to get him his second sack now of the afternoon.
Well, so much for setting the tone of the drive offensively. Giving up a big sack that loses that kind of yardage, not a great start.
Two receivers left, one to the right.
Here we go. Green, 39.
Now Bradford on second down. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. He was trying to get that one to Darren Sproles. And they're going to be staring at a third and long here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. So here's third and 20, and with a long yardage, defense going with a nickel look. Third and long for Bradford. Screen pass to Sproles. And he's able to get up here to the 26. Call it a gain of 13 yards on the play. And it'll be fourth down.
When you run a screen pass really well, you got to like the look of it because so many parts come together to make it work well. The offensive linemen where they're faking people out, the back slipping out there, catching the football, then all of them going together as one unit downfield, a really nice pickup.
This is brought in at the 21. A beautiful fake. 12 yards on the return that time. And out will come the offense as they take over. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. And last time they were able to churn some clock, they got the field goal, added onto their lead, but that was a drive that was so long, it should have ended in a touchdown. You know that's how they felt.
And we'll both be headed to the airport after the game, but we probably should go to the post-game press conference because someone's going to ask the head coach about this drive, and he's going to profess that he was happy to get points.
But
and we know that's not true. Okay, after this type of a drive, not getting a touchdown, a huge disappointment.
Baldwin with it over the middle. A nice gain of 21 yards. Offense comes to the line now, first and 10.
When you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
He reads defenses so well, doesn't he?
He really does, and the best part about that play for him, I don't think that was his primary target.
I don't think so either.
I think he had the read, figured out where the blitz was coming from, and went to a secondary target for a really nice game.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. That is caught at the 7, and he's brought down. A good pick up there of 20 yards. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. To throw again is Wilson. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Connor Barwin in there to get him for a loss of 5.
Well, that was point counterpoint, wasn't it? They decided to throw for it on first and goal. Instead, the defense counters with pressure, and the defense wins, getting a big sack.
On second down, here's Wilson. And that's Curse for the Seattle touchdown, hauling it in. Jermaine Curse, an 11-yard touchdown. And the Seahawks find a way to stretch their lead. Here's Hauschka for the extra point.
You know, in golf, they often talk about playing the course and not worrying about what the other players are doing, what their scores are. That's essentially what we're seeing from this offense. They're just having fun and doing what they feel like doing today.
Get out to send this one away following the score. Short kick. One of the up middle take it now.
Now that's the kind of return that warms the heart of a special teams coach. He'll be pushing us next time, Brandon, to make sure his guys are introduced in the starting lineups. These guys have such an influence on every game. The unsung heroes, remember, they have their own meetings, their own practice time, heck, their own spot on the bench in order to be ready to play each and every week.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. Second and 10. It's Wilson again. It's caught on the left side by Baldwin. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly. And my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you totally. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in the trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
Now, this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. Hausch get out to send this one away following the score. This one taken from the 7. Oh, the spin. And he'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And out now come the Eagles. And down on the scoreboard, certainly needing to avoid what happened on the last drive, punting the football.
Here we go now. Green 90.
Sense of urgency has to take over for them here. They know the score. They know the situation. And by the way, the punter no longer exists for their offense. That's how they have to treat this drive.
They need points.
Big time.
So the incomplete pass brings up second down.
Here we go now. Blue 45. Blue 45.
On second down, Bradford again. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. Give him 8 on the play, and they're going to face a third down.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
Here we go now.
Bradford on 3rd and 2. And that is incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver. And that's going to make it 4th down. Here's Donnie Jones now. He's been one of their few bright spots so far. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. This is taken at the 23. Time for a break. We'll come back and wrap up garbage time after this. So it's Seahawk football as we march toward a conclusion. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. The Seahawks offense now, they get ready to come back onto the field. They have the big lead here late. They protected their home turf well, didn't they?
They certainly did.
Pressure comes and Wilson's going to go down. Michael Kendricks from his outside linebacker spot. He gets him down here for a loss of 4. Oh, Wilson going to throw. And this is caught. It's Jimmy Graham. And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. But I believe a Seahawk was able to get a handle on this, so this will remain Seattle ball. But call it luck or skill, whatever the case is, they're feeling good about just keeping the football there.
Yeah, the biggest thing that they're calling it now, our ball. I mean, they don't care if it was luck or skill, or the panic that jumps up in your chest when that ball's on the ground. Whether you get it or your teammate gets it, just as long as you retain possession, that's all you're looking for.
Second down here after the incomplete pass. Again on 2nd and 10, it's Wilson. This complete to Lockett. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. And there they got him the ball. Just get it to him. Let him do the rest.
You know, he probably said that to his quarterback as he broke the huddle. I like the play call. Just get it to me. I'll take care of the rest of it.
Helping out his rack, right? RAC.
Run after catch. And he loves that. And he's going to carry that in at contract time.
Now Hausch could attack on the extra point. Now he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now as he knocks another one through to extend the lead. Hauschka now to send this one away following the score. Here's Huff to return. And he'll take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. And now the Eagles offense back out onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in a game like this and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
Second down, Bradford, and the hit jarred loose. It's incomplete. Matthews unable to hang on, and that'll bring up a third down. And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion.
Here we go now, 3:39.
Third and short yardage, Bradford, and this is going to be incomplete. Here's Donnie Jones now. He's been terrific so far. .46 on his first kick. This one in that neighborhood as well. Fielded just inside the 20. So a change of possession here on the punt. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. The Seattle now ready to march out of the field. They have the dream scenario you hope for coming into the game. Just one kneel here, and this game should be over.
It's always the final play of preparation each week. The practicing of the kneel down formation, the victory formation. We've got a game in hand, and that's all they're going to want to do now. They'll put someone back deep just in case something goes haywire. But all in all, take the snap, kneel down, and shake hands. Yes, get out of there.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. And we're back. The offense had a chance to talk things over. We'll see what they come up with here on this next play. And this looks to probably be the final play. Rawls, the lone man in the backfield. Here's Wilson. It's caught. Lockett. And he's brought down after a good game. And this is one of those, Charles, as broadcasters, we dread a little bit. We had to go deep into the stat sheets and notebooks to find stuff to talk about.
I hope you didn't notice, but I was stealing your notes as the game went along. I was like, Brandon was ready to go. Plenty of information. I start stealing from page 15 and 16 before you even look down.
That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. It's a win for the